Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi taala wabarakatuh. And a very good afternoon folks. Selamat tengah hari. Salam hari Khamis. Hari ini 30 hari bulan April 2020 bersamaan dengan kejap Jumaat, Sabtu, Ahad, Isnin, Selasa, Rabu, Khamis, 7 Ramadan 1441 Hijriah. Hope that you guys at home are feeling awesome still. Hari ini petang ni di PJ di Lembah Kelang macam hujan-hujan, macam best kan, duduk dalam rumah lagi-lagi bulan puasa ni. Yelah, dah lah tak dapat keluar rumah, lepas tu kau duduk dalam rumah dengan hujan kat luar, aircon tak payah pasang, macam chill, relax kan, natural aircon. But don't worry, because why? I am back again with Sembang Sempoi untuk menyajikan konten-konten yang terkini dengan tetamu-tetamu yang hebat yang saya bawakan kepada anda semua. Alright. Untuk minggu ini, untuk hari ini sebenarnya, we got a very special guest who's going to be talking to us about something that we really, really need to take care of. Not just internally, dari orang kata susuk tubuh badan kita, pemakanan kita dan sebagainya, but also the largest organ that we have as human beings, which is da-da-da-dang, kulit. You guys tak tahu sebenarnya kan, skin is actually the largest organ that we have on our human body. And we actually have a specialist. We have a doctor, a certified doctor, who will be talking to us about how important it is to take care of your skin, especially when you are lacking the vitamin A, I think, from the sunlight. I'm not sure. She will definitely correct me on this. I do not sure, but I know there's multiple vitamins out there. She's going to be educating us, also advising us on what is the best way to take care of ourselves during this MCO when it comes to skin care. And ladies and gents, without further ado, let me introduce to you the awesome, the beautiful, the Russian doll, because she actually spent a lot of her time studying in Russia. Ladies and gents, Dr. Alina Hansni. Hello. Assalamualaikum.
Здравствуйте. Здравствуйте.
Нет, нет. Yang itu je aku tahu, нет. Aku tak kerti.
Нет, no.
Exactly. How are you, doctor? How are you? Apa khabar kita?
Hi. Thank you. Thank you for contacting me. How are you? How are you yourself?
I am as well as one can be. Ramadan ketujuh masih lagi dalam, kita baru saja masuk fasa keempat dalam PKP. We are in the fourth phase of the MCO. I hope that during this MCO period, ever since it was implemented back in on the 18th of March, it has been good to you in one way or another.
It has been fantastic. Like for me, I feel that I can like learn new stuff. I spend a lot of time learning about new stuff. Your camera is like slowed down. I'm not sure why.
And I believe that you have started vlogging again. The fact that you have this much time, and you were a vlogger before. You're very active,
yeah,
vlogging when you were in Russia and when you started your career back here in KL. But you left it quite a bit, and then now you're back at it because there's nothing else to do, isn't it?
I'm here after 13 years. After 13 years, and I'm back and vlogging in vlogging world, because I feel that I don't know. It's kind of like, you remember those days when you were overseas, right? You just stay inside the house by yourself. Well, not by myself. I have my kids. It's just that, you know, you just want to vent out. You just want to find a platform. We just want to talk and discuss, I don't know, something like that. So I feel that
exactly. We're humans. We are meant to socialize as much features. As we can. Yeah, and I mean, like, you know, I'm so glad that we have this, like, you know, four edges of the screen over here, at least we can interact as much as possible, and not just interact but also be informative. Dan juga orang kata bukan tin kosong lah bila kita berborak, bila kita sembang-sempoi ni. Okay, Dr. Alina, most of us know, a lot of people know you definitely as a dermatologist. You're actually a specialist when it comes to skin treatment, skin, anything that has to do with the human skin.
That include your hair, your nails as well.
Okay, hair, I don't really have much comment on that because I have a full set of hair, as you can see. No, of course not. I do not have hair. But again, it's actually part of your, whatchamacallit, part of your syllabus, part of your things that you look at.
It's part of the nila, because dermatology is everything that lines your body's integumentary system.
Okay. The terminology has actually come out right now. So yeah, this is going to be very interesting indeed. Walaupun isteri saya seorang doktor, tapi when it comes to derma, dia macam hilang sikit lah. I know about the everything. Okay, let's talk directly. Let's dive into it. When we talk about skin conditions, when we talk about skincare, memang bila orang cerita pasal dermatologist, most of us, most of humans, most of Malaysians, I think I speak for myself in saying that diorang akan cerita pasal, okay, how to take care of your skin, macam mana nak bagi skin kekal lembut, macam mana nak tak nak bagi kulit merekah, macam mana kita nak hilangkan jeragat dan sebagainya. So, dengan MCO ni, dengan PKP, Perintah Kawalan Pergerakan ni, as we all know, we can't go out. Does that mean that our skin will definitely be better sebab kita duduk rumah? We're not exposed to any pollution. We're not exposed to extra sunlight. Kita duduk rumah aja. Can we just like stay as it is without doing anything to our skin?
Okay. Well, basically with the skin, it's all about balance, Mio. It's about balance. So whenever if you're outside, it's just about balance. It's about getting the right balance. So in terms of oil production, in terms of exposure, which is just now you're saying about, you know, less sun exposure. I rasa if we were to stay in Glasgow, that would be like a serious point. Why? Yeah, because Glasgow has not have our sunlight like this.
It's sun. People in Glasgow will go like, what sun? What is sun?
They have three days of summer and that's it. And they're, you know, they're raining and everything. So highly likely that vitamin D deficiency is very serious over there. But in Malaysia,
it's vitamin D. Damn, I got it wrong. Ya Allah, vitamin D. What
happened to me?
Yeah. I shot myself in the foot actually, but yeah, okay.
So basically vitamin D are like it's for our own bones, right? It's for the strength of it. It's for the calcium, you know. So right now in Malaysia, with our rate of sun exposure, I don't really think that's going to be like such a huge problem, to be honest with you.
Okay.
But there are people who are, you know, like very fragile like that, and they just stay indoors, and they, like, of course you couldn't go out, and they already have enclosed, when you close everything, is physically the sunlight cannot get in. So that will be just that kind of problem. But in Malaysia so far, kurang. It's just right now, yang I dengar, a lot of my patients have been complaining is about their acne start coming up, their dry patches. Yeah, because, you know, of stress and everything, hair falls. A lot of hormonal imbalance and that.
Okay. Bila you sebut hair fall, dia macam automatically akan macam nak mengusap kepala. But No. Funny you should mention.
You should keep that. That's actually your knee already. Thumbprint.
Yeah, this is me. This my thumbprint. Okay.
Yeah,
we're putting at it. Okay.
From like years ago, and that's him. This is him.
Yeah, okay, cool, fine. Okay, I nak pergi kejap lagi, I belanja you, I hantar you boost kejap lagi. Okay, coming back to, when you said about it, it's not just about the environmental issues, it's also about something within, dari segi stress, because stressness and the unbalance of your hormones internal can actually also induce all of this oily skin ataupun acne ataupun kekeringan that's happening around you. Benda ni akan menjadi faktor juga, kan?
Yes, exactly. Because why? Talking about stress, when you have when you have stress, you have oxidative stress. So these are the free radicals that's affecting you from outside to the level of the skin, to the inside, to up to the cellular level. So we're talking about all those reactions that's making you, can I say, age faster? I can say that.
Okay.
And people get like, you know, some... For example, a few days back, I just did a vlog on graying of the hair, premature graying of the hair. So it is, some of it is because of stress as well. Because when you have high oxidative stress, you have more of less of the enzyme that can keep all the hair nice and, you know, just
silky smooth as it should be, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. With the stress also, it has, basically you can imagine our skin are like the biggest organ ever, and it has all the little elements in it that interacts with each other. So these they interact with each other by mediums, by our hormones. So hormones are like those to balance it out. So if you have a little bit of more stress than your oil production, for example, if you're the oily type, right, your oil production more. And then if you do not take care of that, then it'll cause acne.
All right. Okay. Coming back to that, because again, during normal times, pre-MCO, pre-PKP, you know, normal times people can go out and then, like, you know, they wear products on their faces, they wear suntan on their lotion on their skin, and everything. So, you know that's normal, because right now sekarang ni pula you are indoors, and then like there's other factors yang mempengaruhi dari segi your daily lives and everything. So by during this MCO period, is it more products yang sebenarnya seseorang tu kena pakai sebenarnya, ataupun it highly depends on what condition that you are in that particular moment? I mean, like, how do you find that out? Because you're alone, you can't really see really professional advice. Takkanlah kita kat kulit sikit-sikit je, tiba-tiba nak pergi jumpa derma and everything. I don't know, is that actually a good thing to go and see a derma in this moment in time? What's your advice?
Okay, so basically for me, if you have like conditions whereby it's not affecting your health, you know, it's not life-threatening, then you can just like deal with it at home. So for example, like basic cases, like acne or dry skin, that one you can do at home. So you just basically have to put in place the right skincare routine. Doesn't mean that you have to put, you know, like all the 80 layers that you've been putting outside.
Yep, Mia, I've seen those happening. Yes.
Yeah, if you look at it from a like a silver lining point of view, you get to have skin fasting. Do you know what skin fasting is, Mia?
I mean, like layman terms, fasting for the skin lah. Itu je lah,
kan? Exactly. So when you're inside, you don't really need to put anything. You don't really need to put anything on top of, you know, cosmetically, and you know, just to cover up all the blemishes outside, because you don't meet people, right? Just except for maybe. You know, sections like that. But it's a good time to start actually knowing your own skin by not having anything on your skin, like cosmetically, I mean makeup. You can actually see whether your skin is it at a healthier state, or is it like, you know, is it not? And then you can treat it.
So you're sort of like resetting yourself. Dia macam balik ke ground zero and see what's happening and what's good and what's bad, kan? Ada juga aku ni sebenarnya.
Yeah, sangat, very. So that's basically the concept is that, because you can stay at home, you apply this time, and you know what? Imagine this: people with pigmentation can actually have lesser pigmentation when they stay at home. That is so good news.
Wow. Okay, but that's also that's true. But that's also a fashion or a trend setting. Kalau macam ada, you know, pigmentation and everything, you know, macam freckles and everything, you know, like, oh, aku orang putih, aku ada freckles and everything. Tapi itu sebenarnya it's all in the genes, isn't it? Is it really fall down to proper skincare, or is it in the genes when you talk about freckles?
Oh, okay. So freckles, when you're like in primary school, if you already have freckles during primary school, it's actually genetic. It's not like a sunspot or anything. But if you start having freckles, like, you know, when you start like 20 above, 25 above, 30, and then that's more of accumulated sun damage throughout the year.
Okay.
Accumulated sun damage is actually the damage that you have accumulated. So for example, one day you keluar 30 minutes, right, outside, and you go back, you don't wear anything during the 30 minutes. So that's fine. So that's like underneath. So what happens is that when we're younger, things changes under the skin, but it doesn't show on top of the surface. But as you grow older and older and older, it becomes like everything comes out.
Things are coming out, slowly creeping out, like before you know it, everything is just like inside out and everything. Okay, funny you should mention about sun and everything, because obviously we Malaysians living in Malaysia, 365, 24/7, every single freaking day, the sun is always there, except kalau ada hujan lebat dan sebagainya lah. Exactly. So suntan lotion. When we talk about sunscreen, jenis application, because I've seen a video previously, a YouTuber or somebody, I can't remember, who did some sort of a test, the different effects of certain different types of suntan lotions and sun and sunscreens. Contohnya ada yang pakai sapu, ada yang pakai spray, ada yang SPF 30, ada SPF 15 and everything. You, being a skin specialist, being a derma, for Malaysians, what is the magic number that one should actually buy in regards of suntan lotion sebenarnya? Because ada setengah-setengah sampai SPF 150. Is it possible? Ada sampai 150?
Well, it boils down to actually the marketing side. Because of course, when you want to use all these like numbers, okay. Basically, for us, we can use, the best is actually to use SPF 30. 30 to 50 is fine. Okay. SPF just cover you from one wavelength. We still have other wavelength that's affecting our skin. So SPF only cover UVB.
UVB, okay.
UVB is the one that causes burning on your skin. Mm-hmm. So the UVA that goes inside and cause aging and cause delayed pigmentation, all that, UVA goes much, much deeper. And these is not protected by SPF alone. It has to be protected by, kalau you tengok sun protection, it has to say PA there. P, A and then plus plus, it depends.
Okay, all right. This kind of realization makes me scared, makes me like super scared to even go out, because sebenarnya there's a lot of things that can actually harm you, but you should not be scared because there are also ways for you to protect yourself sebenarnya kan.
Yeah, exactly. Well, it depends. Actually, this one is more like a personal choice. It's more like because us Malaysians, we have the kind of melanin that protects us. Well, not most of us, and I'm not saying 100% doesn't develop skin cancer, but the likely of us developing skin cancer is low because of the level of melanin that we have, because of the skin color that we have, because we're not.
Because we are from this part of the world, because we're not Europeans who are suddenly being put in the middle of the equator, right?
Yes. So, like at this point, it's about the premature aging lah, because honestly, to tell you, my husband do not like wearing sun protection at all, but he got so he's fine, I guess, for the next, I don't know, 20 years.
But how does that work, the fact that you are a derma and you don't have the power to apa memaksa suami?
You have no idea, seriously.
Well, as long as you guys are happy and you guys know what to do, I think that's fine.
The best thing is that whenever his acne comes up, right, he'll be like, where's your product? Like, I really need that product now. Like, okay, fine, go ahead.
No, okay. Cool. It's cool that you mentioned that, because ramai, I mean, like, there's a lot of people out there, a lot of us Malaysians, tak kisahlah, whatever age that you're at, we normally react to stuff rather than preempt of something that is going to happen, kan? A lot of us are always like that. Kita bila dah terantuk baru nak mengadah, rather than making an effort to prepare yourselves before these things actually happen. So when it comes to skincare, what are the things that you sepatutnya prepare yourself with untuk menjaga, make sure kulit you baik, bukan saja muka, malah tangan, kaki, buku lali dan sebagainya, your tumit and whatnot and everything. What are the things that you need to be taken care of before things actually happen?
Okay, so for the skin, because our skin throughout the body, right? So our skin at different places of our body have different thickness. Yeah. And the way they react is totally different. And because some of the skin are like prone to the sun, they are exposed to the sun. So the risk is different than those maybe at your back, you know, when you wear baju and all that. So it's about maintaining that balance, right? So the balance is that, okay, like for the skin, for example, you need to be able to make sure that it's on the optimum level of moisture. So you need to have facial wash in, you need to have toner in just to balance everything out, and the moisturizers if you need. If you don't, you just, you know, use your sun protection. But using sun protection in-house is very important as well, because it will actually reduce, yes, the risk of pigmentation that's going to come up, and also premature skin aging, which honestly, most guys don't care. Including my husband.
Because you guys
can macam baby face and you know have no problem with
You know, that face is actually a face of a 25-year-old. But bila dia orang tahu umur saya sebenarnya, dia orang terkejut. But you cannot deny, doctor. But nowadays, there's a lot of men right now who are really into, you know, really taking care of their skin. Ada ramai. No, I do not know whether it's a marketing point of view. Maybe because the fact that Beckham has been, you know, having his own product. Contohnya, Biotem. I think Beckham is the face of Biotem. Ataupun, you know, there's other models and everything. You perhaps promoting men's skincare solutions and everything. Is it just a marketing scheme? Ataupun, are men really taking notice of really taking care of their skin?
But you look, if you look at it from that point of view, we are actually a creature who wants to be confident in whatever that we're in. So we will actually seek that. So it depends. It doesn't matter whether your gender is male or female. You really wanted to, you know, feel confident about yourself. So the issue, the main point here is the confidence level that you are in. You want to be confident in your own skin. So certain people are confident, are already confident in their own skin, which is fine. It's fine. But other people are not really that confident because they have certain ailments in their skin. So again, it's up to us individually. It's like a reflection of us. How do we feel about ourselves? It's not to say that, okay, have a lot of acne and feel good about it. It's not that. It's just about, yeah, it's about maintaining the right healthy skin rather than opt for, you know, like glowy and like putih and all that. A lot of people, I mean, I think it's good that right now the education is in place. We don't go to the extent of, you know, making our face like very very fair just because we, you know,
I mean kalau nak jadi macam Michael Jackson tu, I think it will be too much of an extreme because you got a total, you know, proper black dark African American suddenly jadi like whitey as white as snow, because that's just gonna be seriously scary kalau tengah-tengah malam jalan macam pakai telekung semua everything. I'm gonna be like jumping out of my car. Yes, okay. You mentioned about, yes, products. Yeah, okay. Let's go towards consumers. Let's talk about products that are out there right now. As you, definitely of all people would know that there's so many different products out there yang sebenarnya menjanjikan apa yang something yang illogical. Because okay, they can come and suddenly like, you know, eat our product or use our products, then suddenly like you'll become as white as snow, or you'll become, you know, you'll lose all your acne in just like 72 hours, those kind of things and everything. All these claims and whatnot, it is definitely wrong, right? I mean, like from pengeluar's point of view, to actually claim such things for your product, isn't it?
Yes, exactly. That's why we, as doctors, we actually hold on to evidence-based medicine. Evidence-based meaning, okay, if you claim it to be this, what do you have? What kind of evidence do you have to support this? So, for example, for acne, you have acne and your acne will resolve. So that's what we bring. In my company, we hold on to actually give more transparency to our patients, more clarity in order for them to understand that what kind of ingredients that can affect the skin, that can help the skin. That's what we're doing right now. So, sorry?
No, I'm not talking to you. There's somebody who just came down and sent me some stuff talking about things that duduk rumah, beli barang-barang macam ni je.
Right. Yeah, right. Itulah, I nampak post laju pun a lot of ni already. So yeah.
Sorry. Go continue.
Apa dah tadi? I pun dah lupa dah.
about how doctors actually use proof before they claim such product actually do what it says that it does and everything. I mean, like false claims and everything is so widespread, and people are being caught every single day when it comes to this thing.
Okay, so basically the concept is not to fall easily for all this marketing scheme. Okay, when they say like, you know, your jeragat will be gone in maybe 7 days or maybe 3 days, something like that, it's not possible. It is not possible. So you cannot have that. So you have to go into more detail in terms of ingredients. For example, you look for something that's a bit more exfoliating, and even exfoliants, you have like both. You have chemical peel, you have like chemical exfoliants, and you have physical exfoliants. So chemical exfoliants, like, you know, AHA, alpha hydroxy acids, are those for drier skin, and for beta hydroxy acid for oilier skin. So you have to know all these like key words in getting the right skincare for your skin.
Okay, so it's not as simple as somebody just come up over the counter, then I need something, and lagi-lagi lah kalau that particular person is not really a certified personnel from the industry to actually give you some advice on what products will be good for you. They would normally go on testimonials more than anything else.
Well, to be honest with you, we have a lot of skincare enthusiasts, and I love skincare enthusiasts because they're very enthusiastic in promoting skincare. It doesn't matter if they own have their own line of skincare. It's just about discovering different skincare for, because you know what? The world has so many resources. We have so many skincare in the world that can help you. We just want to understand which ingredients are suitable for your skin and what kind of like inactives that can, you know, bring the active ingredients to actually affect your skin. That's it, really. So it doesn't matter who you get your advice.
Yeah, that's true.
You need to get the right advice. So it's not necessarily that okay, you're a doctor, only doctors and dermatologists can advise you on skincare. No, I won't say that. But it's just that if they got the right advice, then they would be fine. It is fine with me. I have no problem with that. Yeah.
Lovely, cool. Okay. Now let's talk about the perception of price. More expensive it is, the higher probability that this product would work, because there's so many products out there, as you mentioned. Banyak sangat produk yang ada dekat luar sana where people are, you know, selling off and everything. Obviously, you got your name brands and then you got your not so name brands and everything. When it comes to the layman, when it comes to people who are maybe, you know, in the B40 class, who can't really afford as much, you know, buying all this, you know, like T20 types of products and everything. They say to themselves, like, I can only afford this one. So is it okay to have that kind of a mentality? It doesn't mean that if it's cheap, it doesn't work. Ataupun if it's expensive, that it's definitely the best in the market.
Yeah. Okay, it doesn't mean that when it's expensive, it's going to work for your skin. It doesn't mean that, you know, cheap products in drugstores, for example, in the pharmacy, could not help your skin. It's about knowing your own skin. What kind of products, what kind of consistency, what kind of ingredients that you want to be in your skin in order to help, you know, relieve from your ailments. So these are the knowledge that's like a little bit more, you know, technical, and you know, we need more guidance. But just to say the fact that, you know, more expensive brands and more expensive, it's just the way they do the product, they make the manufacture the product. So maybe the more expensive brands, they have, because you have to understand, they pay attention to quality, to details, to the kind of active ingredients and the surrounding inactive ingredients that you know, that helps with the active ingredients. So that's a different matter. So, you know, yeah, for me, as long as your skin is healthy afterwards, is fine with me. That's why my company name is my company tagline is your skin only better. So it doesn't matter what you're using, as long as it's
exactly
better.
Exactly. Tapi kadang-kadang, you know, I have to admit myself, sometimes whenever I go out, you know, to a pharmacy, whenever I want to go buy a moisturizer and everything, dia macam rasa macam like, ala, buying a store brand versus buying yang macam like, oh, yang ni macam mahal sikit, mesti macam
Sephora brand.
You know, those kind of things. I think it's just the mentality, the marketing scheme of how things work and everything. So it works differently because, like, not everyone is the same. Your skin and my skin are totally different. My skin and my wife's skin is totally different. So it all depends on how unique you are and how you cater to that uniqueness and how you take care of it.
Exactly. So it's just basically the main guideline is that if you go in, you find something that's, if you find it says for all skin type, then just be careful with that product.
Itu macam typical barangan yang lelaki suka beli, because like we don't go for this and this and this and this. We just buy one that fits everything, 7-in-1 shampoo, that kind of a thing. You know, guys, you know, being macho guys, we don't really see all the time. Oh, masa je benda ni.
I faham. Yeah, I faham. But yeah, well, anyway, it is okay. To be honest with you guys, their skin, men, skin for men is different than women, because the hormones are, you know, they're different.
We're easier to control. We're easier to maintain.
Pretty much. Well, not necessarily, but yeah.
Is that an admission? Is that an admission right there?
But you know what, to be honest, at my center, I've always seen like patients who brought their husband come in, and almost like 95, 99% of their skin is much better than the wife punya skin. Seriously, because in terms of anatomy wise, and then they, you know, they use lesser products, less harsh stuff on their skin. They don't wear makeup, so that's good lah. Actually, yeah, I wish.
It's all about the human anatomy. I mean, like, obviously when you talk about genders, you know, ada kelebihan, ada kekurangan at the end of the day, you know. So it's how you control or how you maintain that of what you have. That's the most important thing, regardless of whoever you are. Sebenarnya kan. All right. So mungkin Doc, you want to give like some tips during bulan Ramadan ni, lagilah dengan MCO. Maybe like, you know, are there any home remedies yang you mungkin boleh share kan? I mean, like something simple that anybody can actually use or that they can use at home. Do you believe in home remedies for people? No, for skincare lah, for skincare. Oh, I mean, okay, first of all, do you believe in home remedies, first of all?
Oh, okay, well, if you have dry skin, you can opt for kalau home remedies. If you have yogurt and you have a little bit of like macam kunyit, you can do that, mix it together, have a little you know, have a little mask there, you can do that. But not necessary, to be honest with you, it's about just maintaining the skin barrier. It's just knowing when to get help, basically. So if you don't have problem, do not find problem.
Jangan nak cuba sesuatu perkara yang mana you tak biasa.
Yeah, exactly.
No, because you know why? Fifth week in MCO, gatal. Semua benda nak cuba, semua benda nak try.
Okay, lagi satu tips, maybe lah, you can try home patch testing. Because you want to know whether that product is suitable for you or not, right? So, for example, you just got...
Is it like one of the scratch testing thing to check allergies and whatnot?
Okay, that is a medical patch testing where they, you know, they check on your back. They put But you can do home patch testing with new products that you buy because you can tengah gatal tangan, you want to try new stuff, you went on Sephora, you know, you just buy stuff. And then when they come,
I don't go on Sephora. Disclaimer, sekuat-kuatnya aku tak pernah pergi Sephora punya website, pergi kedai dengan wife ada.
So home patch testing, you just like put the solution or anything that's new that you bought, just maybe around here or around behind your legs, and you just observe it for at least minimum 48 hours. And if you have any redness around those areas, then you have to be careful because that might have a different reaction on your skin. So it could be irritating for your skin. So if you know that earlier up front, that's a good tip for just to apply. Yeah.
And any tip for me to keep my head always shining, because I've been using only baby oil. Seriously, ini nasihat yang ditagih.
You know what? You don't know aging at all. Seriously, from the last time I saw you. So that's
okay,
really
good. What's your home address? I will send some food.
I want tea life, a bang bang, please.
Again, we're kind of like blessed with whoever you is, where we are, apa yang kita buat. Tapi again, this may not be aging, but other parts, tulang, lutut, semua dah longgar, dok. Itu semua dah lembik lah, itu dah tak tahan lah tu.
I think your nutrition, the nutrition is very important as well, because now nak jadi chef, right? So everybody's like cooking, baking and stuff. All this high GI food. Even myself, seriously, like, you know, I do like cakes. You know those cakes you put in the microwave and it comes out? And
jadi tak?
Jadi, tapi masalahnya, after a while, it gets into your skin. It does stuff to your skin. So, you know, you end up with breakouts and stuff. So it depends on your skin. It depends on the, I don't know, the threshold, the strength of your skin kot, whether you boleh tahan or not.
It's susah, you nak indulge when you're actually a derma and then you nak kena fikir semua benda ni. Okay, hey, Doc, we're actually running in about 34 minutes now. Wow, time really flies.
Yeah, it is.
So, last words from you to our viewers. Maybe you want to share something before we leave.
For me, just keep using some protection. Get the right routine of skincare. If you want to know what kind of skin type you want, you can go to www.dermaline.com. We have a testing there. You just can answer a few questions there, and you can get yourself tested and see whether, you know, you're on the oilier side or you're on drier side. And then, you know, yeah. Basically, get the right skincare for yourself and don't forget your sun protection and take care of your fluid, take care of your food. Yeah, that's it, really.
Exactly. And one more thing, where can they find you on Instagram? Dr. Alina Hasni is on Instagram. What about Dermaline?
Oh, Dermaline, we have dermaline.malaysia. You can go on Instagram, dermaline.malaysia, or you can just go to my Instagram, which is Dr. Alina Hasni. You can press it there. I put on the link to my to my business accounts. Yeah.
So if you guys want to get a second second thought ataupun like second consultation. directly from Dr. Alina, you can actually pass her on, DM her on IG. She'll be able to actually address your concerns, inshallah, before Raya ni. That's all the time that we have right now. Thank you so much, Dr. Alina Hasni, for coming on. Thank you for making yourself
famous now that you brought me on.
Dan Boyo mengada gedi. All right, that's it for now, folks. Hope you guys are having an awesome day. Thank you so much, and hope that this
show has
for you guys as well. So as always, duduk di rumah, kita jaga kita, dan jom Malaysia kita putuskan rantaian COVID-19 ini bersama-sama, sebab kita nak raya nanti tak lama lagi. Alright, see you. Bye-bye, Dr. Alina. Say bye-bye.
Alright, see you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. Thank you. Bye-bye. 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 Bye-bye.